Hello, today I want to talk to you about a topic that I've heard many times before, but today I was hiking and I was listening to a short book. I think it's probably only a 60-page book. It's called Money Wants You. It was written as a series of articles back in 1903 by Henry Harrison Brown. And I listened to it in the audio version as I was hiking, and it highlighted some things that I think are really important. And given where we're at with COVID and just the world right now, I thought I would share this with you. And when you boil it all down, it comes down to our attitude about money and broadly that which you want in your life. So I'm going to try to do my best at breaking down an hour-long book into less than 5 minutes. Essentially, this is a lesson that I've, and probably you have heard thousands of times before, from as far back as the Bible and maybe earlier teachings, I don't know. But for me, probably most notably was a book from Bob Proctor called You Were Born Rich. And it really has to do about our attitude about money and really all things. But I'm going to use money because it's the easiest one. So if you have this attitude that you need money, it's scarcity, there's not enough money, and you're like a slave to money, you're probably pushing it away. And here's my example. Think about some time in your life where you walked into a room, you watched a video, you watched anything, you encountered somebody, and you got this crazy negative energy from them. And maybe you're like, that person's so needy. Well, let me tell you, if you go into your life feeling in lack, you are giving that energy out to other people. And you're like, well, what does that have to do with my money? Well, here's the deal. If you have this like negative belief about money and that you're broke, what you're doing is you're preventing opportunity from coming your way. Really, I know it sounds crazy, but it's true. If you have the vision, and this is the thing that the book and Bob Proctor says, you have the vision that you've got what you want and you have the confidence and you know that when you get some traction and some opportunity that you won't squander it and you'll invest, whether that be the money or the time to the relationship or hard work to an opportunity, whatever it is, as long as you hold yourself in your mind with a positive vision of what you want and feel that self-confidence, allow that momentum in your body, that will shift your energy and it'll open up the doors of opportunity to you. And I know it sounds crazy, but there's a lot of, you know, go online, go to YouTube, you know, Bruce Lipton, Dr. Joe Dispenza, there's so much out there that says, with the right attitude, and I'm not saying not to do the work, but the attitude is the critical thing because it's your energy level. When your energy level is good and positive, doors open to you that won't. When you're always looking down, you can't see the horizon. My father used to yell at me all the time when I was a kid, and I never got it till later in life. He was always like, keep your eyes forward, always look for what's going on the horizon. And if you're always down, depressed because you don't have, you'll never see what's out there. And now more than ever, with all this crap going on with coronavirus, there's more opportunity because there's the opportunity to solve problems. And we all know that the biggest fortunes are made when you're able to help other people and solve their problems. So I hope that this very short video will open your eyes to it. And down below, there'll be a link to the actual video, and there'll be a link to Bob Proctor's book. But honestly, if you find yourself, you know, dwelling on what you don't have, try this out. I know it can help. It's helped me so many times, and I know I've been the recipient. It's how I got into the real estate business, completely long and random story. And it's also how most recently I've gotten a couple great opportunities with some startup companies and some other opportunities that I can't really discuss right now. But just go ahead, check it out for yourself, see what you think, and let me know your results. I'd really like to hear back from you. Take care and have a great day.